Ladies and gentlemen, the following preview has been approved for all audiences by the folks at Crossover Church. Crossover is engaging with this film solely for the purpose of highlighting spiritual ideas. Please use your own discretion and wisdom if you choose to view this film in its entirety.
Yeah, Crossover, come on, make some noise for my guy, Lil Luke. Yeah. So welcome to Back to School Sunday, and we wanted to give you guys a little taste of what the kids are doing back in the gym. They're all getting free backpacks and school supplies today. You saw all the bounce houses and all the fun stuff that they're doing. Even the teenagers are out there having a good time as well. And they got Lil Luke going back there now to do a concert for them. So give it up for him one more time. Yeah. So if you're new at Crossover, welcome. We love our city. You see a lot of the shirts around here. We have a big heart to serve and give back to the community. And this is actually our final week of the series that we've been doing called Summer Fun at the Movies, where we've been looking at different movies and pulling out spiritual truths and lining it up with God's word. And so kind of walking through the series so far, we looked at the movie Hypnotic. We talked about how sin can sometimes like hypnotize us. Then the second week we looked at A Man Called Otto. Did anybody go and watch Otto since it came? It's on Netflix. And we talked about loneliness that day. We talked about suicide. We talked about friendship and being a good neighbor. It was powerful. Then we went deep on week three. We talked about Till. And then Till talks about racism and injustice. It was some heavy stuff. Then we lightened it up a little bit with Little Mermaid. And we talked about learning to find our voice. And last week we had Top Gun Part 2. Anybody seen Top Gun? Any Top Gun fans in the building? Talked about being on a mission. And at the same time, we celebrated a big milestone for your boy. Turned 50 last week. So I just want to pause and say thank you to you guys for just showing me love, for wishing me happy birthday, all the notes that you guys wrote, cards, gifts, just pictures we took together. Man, you guys made last week so special. The sneaker ball was amazing. It was awesome. Yeah, so thank you guys for letting me be your pastor. I love y'all. I love y'all. So today, somebody say today, we are going to be looking at the movie Jesus Revolution. And I'm curious, how many of you guys have seen Jesus Revolution? Anybody seen it? I highly recommend it. It's a movie that really resonated with me, and I actually got emotional a couple times because I'm getting old now, you know. It was just a couple thug tears that I had, you know. But I got emotional a couple times because, like, the movie mirrored a lot of Crossover Church's story. Yes, it was different culture, different time, different people, but there was a lot of principles that were very similar to Crossover Church's story. And it even tied in with my story. I'm a pastor's kid. I'm a PK, so I grew up with one foot in the church because every time the church doors opened, I had to be there. But yet I grew up in Philly, so I had one church in the streets, and I was into hip-hop and basketball and these two different worlds that I was in and trying to navigate, and they were very different. They were very separate at the time. And so when I... Hey, we got any PKs in the building, any pastor's kids? We got a couple. We were the worst, right? We were the worst. Watch out for us, right? I had a rebellious season. I was wilding out. I was a prodigal son, but God got a hold of me and drew me back to the Lord my second semester of college. And I got on fire for God, and I built this authentic relationship with Jesus. There was a Jesus revolution that happened inside of me. And so now I'm like, man, I want to go to the basketball courts and talk to people about Jesus and weave in my faith and talk to people and invite them to church. And so that's what I did. I started inviting people to church because the people on the basketball court, they didn't go to church, right? So I met this dude named Carlos, and Carlos had never been to church in his life, never been a Christian church ever. And he was like a young adult at the time. So I invited him, and he finally came after about the third time I invited him. I had to go pick him up, actually. And so he showed up at church, and that's the day that I realized the church has a problem. Because, you know, this was back in the 90s, and our church had this unspoken dress code. Everybody wore suits and ties and dresses. I mean, that's what most churches did back in the 90s. A lot of them still do it today. But if you don't have church clothes, you're not welcomed. And I didn't think it was a big deal. He's like, well, I don't have any church clothes. I'm like, it's cool, just wear whatever you got. He came in looking like this, and it wasn't cool. People didn't welcome him. People didn't treat him right. People even said some inappropriate comments to him. And I'm just feeling like, man, wait a minute. Like, our church always talks about we were trying to love our neighbor and we're trying to reach our community. And I realized, like, we're not doing that at all. I looked around at our church and, like, this guy, I met him on the basketball court, which was literally across the street from the church at this school, and he lived two blocks away, and nobody else in the church looked like him in dress or even in ethnicity. And I'm like, man, this light bulb went off, and man, it lit a fire inside of me. And I'm like, man, I know I'm called to do ministry. I don't know what it's going to look like someday, but I know I want to create a place where everybody's welcome. No matter what your dress style is, no matter what your skin color is, what your background is, what your bank account looks like, everybody is welcome. So I want to tell you, if you're new here at Crossover Church today, you are welcome. Somebody tell the person next to you, you're welcome. Type that in the chat for those worshiping online. Those online, you are welcome. Jump in with us online, our online family. Make some noise for our online family. I had this fire and this passion and said, man, I want to create a church where everybody truly is welcome. And so I wanted to reach urban culture and hip-hop culture and point them to Jesus and welcome them to church. And so the past 20-plus years, Crossover has been part of a revolution. It's been part of a movement of doing that, welcoming the urban culture, hip-hop culture, like into a church setting. And so some of you here may know this, some of you are new, you may not know it, but our church several years back, over two decades ago, started this urban leadership conference and hip-hop music festival called Flavor Fest. And Flavor Fest was something we trained people. We said, man, here's some scenes from it. We said, we want to train church leaders to plant new churches that are relevant, that are innovative, that are outreach-oriented, that are welcoming everybody in. We want to help churches that are already existing, like, revitalize so they can be relevant and really reach people in their community and welcome everybody in, no matter what their background is. And so over the past two decades, we've trained over 5,000 church leaders right here at Crossover Church. And there are so many stories. So many stories. My guy, Pastor Ernest, where you at? Where you at, Pastor Ernest? Where you at? Give it a stand up real quick. My guy, Pastor Ernest, Higher Dimension Church from Jacksonville. He's here with some of his team today to just kind of come and see what we're doing and see some more vision. He's been in my coaching network. He's been to Flavor Fest many times as well. And this year, we decided to do something crazy and take Flavor Fest on tour. And we never did that before, 23 years into it. And we went to New York City. We went to Los Angeles. We went to Atlanta. A few weeks ago, we went to Houston. And then we're going to be back here the first weekend of November. And our goal this year is to train over 1,000 leaders this year alone, way more than we've ever trained in a year. So you guys are part of a movement. Look at somebody next to you and say, you're part of a movement. It's been a Jesus revolution right here through Crossover Church. You might have not even known about it, right? So the Jesus Revolution movie, it's based in the 1970s, and there was a true story. This whole movie is based on a true story. It's pretty accurate with most of the facts if you fact check it and whatnot. And there was a church that was not reaching the young adult youth culture at that time. And at that time in the 70s, it wasn't hip-hop culture, right? Hip-hop was just being birthed in the Bronx, New York. By the way, hip-hop is turning 50 in a couple weeks. 1973 was a good year. It was a good year. So this church in California, it wasn't reaching hip-hop culture. It was reaching hippie culture. The hippies was a big youth movement in the 60s and the 70s, and they were pretty much usually shunned away from churches. And so that's where kind of, you know, I can resonate with the movie. I'm like, wow, I see a lot of similarities with what Crossover has done over the years. And so this pastor's daughter, a PK, she was a young adult at the time, and she was just like getting more and more turned off with her dad's church and distanced, and, you know, she just felt like she was totally out of place. Her relationship with God was kind of fading, and she met this hippie evangelist and this dude that looked like her, long hair and everything, but was like on fire for Jesus. And she was like, wow, I've never seen anybody like my age that really loves God. And so she's like, you need to meet my dad. And she takes this guy home. So turn your eyes to the screen and check out how this interaction went. Wow. Wow, the Bible says this in Romans chapter 10, verse 14. It says, but how can they call on him to save them unless they believe in him? And how can they believe in him if they've never heard about him? And how can they hear about him unless someone tells them? And how will anyone go, somebody say go, and tell them without being sent? This is why the scripture says, how beautiful are the feet of the messengers who bring good news. Let me tell you something. Crossover Church is a good news church. It's a church that has a shoe game. There's some beautiful feet here at Crossover Church because there's some people that are regularly going out and engaging culture and telling them this good news and welcoming everybody. So today I want to talk to us about how do we spark a Jesus revolution in 2023? How do we do that? Our theme for 2023 at Crossover Church, come on, help me out, family. What is it?
Rebrand.
It's rebrand. It's to change the narrative about the church. Because if we're real, if we're honest, the church is not really having a great reputation right now in mainstream culture. A lot of people think the church is old school, out of touch, boring, judgmental, maybe even racist. I mean, there's just a bad narrative that a lot of people think about the church. And we've been on a mission this year and really even before that to change that narrative. And we love it that every single week there's people that walk in here and they experience what we call church remixed. And they look around and they're like, wow, I didn't know church could be like this. I've never been to a church like this, where the music is like this, and you can be comfortable, and you can be yourself, and you look around the room, and there's people from all walks of life. Everybody is truly welcome, and most of all, they feel God's presence. And so every week, there's stereotypes that are being broken. Some of you are here today for the first time, and you're like, okay, wow, this is different. This is different in a good way, right? So if you're here again for the first time today, We're excited you're here. We're here to rebrand you today. Yeah. God's going to do some new things inside of you today. We believe that. We love to do this. So you're welcome in this house. So how do we create a Jesus revolution? I want to give you three quick things today. Number one is this. We are all messengers. Somebody say messengers. Messengers. Listen, we're all messengers. If you have a relationship with Jesus, Romans chapter 10, verse 15, you know, who's that talking about? It's talking about you. It's talking about me. It's talking about us. We are to have a gospel shoe game. We're to have beautiful feet that we're sharing the gospel. We're going out and regularly making that known. By the way, I just got to say this. Some of y'all got a nice shoe game. Last Sunday, it was a sneaker ball. And we dressed up, a lot of us dressed up, and we wore our kicks, our sneaks, our J's, right? And man, some of y'all were killing it. I just want to say this, though. the sneaker wall where I was taking all the pictures, I got to make a disclaimer. Those were not my shoes. Everybody's like, man, those are nice. I'm like, I wish I had those. That was our photographer, Hope. Y'all give it up for Hope. She got a serious shoe game, for real. There she is right there. Oh, look, she got some Carolina Blue Jays on right now today. She's mild on them, right? But hey, speaking of shoes, if you guys follow me on Instagram, I want to thank you because you helped me choose the cover of my next book. A couple of weeks ago, I put it up there. So come on, give me a drum roll real quick. This is what it looks like right here, and it is called Gotta Be the Shoes, where sneaker culture meets faith. The book is going to be about sneaker culture and faith coming together. There's a lot of cool angles and narratives about it. Pray for me. I'm almost done. I just got a little bit to go. It's in final editing right now, so pray for Pastor T. It's been a lot to juggle, but it's going to drop this fall prayerfully. It's going to come in a shoebox, of course. You know how we do. We got to get creative. But we want people to have a good gospel shoe game, right? So for us as Christians, we're called to be messengers and represent Jesus everywhere we go. And you know, that doesn't mean we have to like get on a bullhorn and start like, hey, repent. And like, not saying we got to do all that, but just simply let your light shine through your actions. Let your light shine through your words, through your deeds. You know, God's going to give you words many times to go up and share with somebody. And I know sometimes when the Holy Spirit taps you on the shoulder, y'all ever been hesitant? You're like, is that really God? Or, you know, what's this person going to think of me? Like, no, God's telling you, you need to go talk to that person. But then when you end up, if you're obedient, you listen to that push from God, like you talk to them and it was a setup. And this person needed to get encouraged that day. This person needed to share their heart that day. This person maybe needed to get prayed for. How many of y'all ever experienced like God set something up and you were obedient and you were like, okay, wow, I'm so grateful that I listened. And guess what? The times that you didn't, you don't even know what you missed out on. Could have been an amazing opportunity. And God will use somebody else if he doesn't use you. He'll use some rocks to cry out, right? So listen, I believe like, look around this room today. You got people from all different parts of the Tampa Bay area, all different backgrounds, all different ages, ethnic groups, economic brackets. If people here truly became authentic messengers and really were spreading the word like on a regular basis, just letting their light shine, y'all, we could change the city. We could change the city. When we leave this building, when we leave this live stream, there's people that go out and could touch almost every slice of this city because our church is so, so diverse, y'all. And so, man, Jesus gives his followers this mission to be messengers. We see it in Matthew chapter 28, starting in verse 19. And this is also known as the Great Commission. And Jesus says, therefore, go. Somebody say, go. Go and do what? Make disciples of what kind of nations? All nations. Look around the room today. We got all nations represented here, all backgrounds, all different dress styles. I mean, look at my guy over there with that amazing outfit, right? African, you got people from different countries in the Caribbean. You got people from New York City, people from the South in Georgia. You got people that, a couple of natives that are from Florida, just Devon. And, you know, but you got you got people from all over that are part of this church family. All nations are represented here because we're going. We're doing it. And then what do? We baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. The scripture, Jesus says, teach these new disciples to obey all the commands that I have given you. And I love this part. Be sure of this. I am with you when? Always. Even to the end of the age. So a Jesus revolution, it starts when his people follow these words right here. When his people go and are about making disciples. And I know that word go can be a little scary. Because I know some of you are introverted. And even the extroverts, it can still be intimidating sometimes to go and minister to somebody or take someone under your wing and disciple them. But man, I love the last part of that verse because Jesus promises us. He says, be sure, I will be with you when? Always. Jesus is with you. So you got this. He's going to guide you. He's going to direct you. He's going to give you the words. He's going to give you the things to say. He's going to show you what to do. In the Jesus Revolution movie, the hippies, they weren't welcome in most churches. Why? because of the way they dressed, or the way they looked. They had long hair. A lot of them didn't even have shoes on. And they were walking in this church, and this church only had a little handful of older people that were all dressed up and stuffy. Suddenly, all these hippies started coming, and they were filling up the church. And you would think the church would be excited, like, oh, man, look at the young people are coming. This is amazing. But there was some of the older people that were complaining. Oh, my goodness, you know, that some of them, you know, they need to wash their feet. The carpet's getting dirty. Like, really? That's what you're worried about? God is cleaning people's hearts, and you're worried that the carpet's getting dirty? Like, come on. You know what? It reminded me of back in the day at Crossover Church when I started the youth ministry in the 90s, and there was really only, like, one teenage girl that her dad went to the church, and there was a few other people in the church that brought their neighbors and stuff, but I had, like, you know, a little handful of a couple teens that were connected to the church, like four in total, my first youth meeting. And the pastor was like, listen, we got this van. It was born the same year as you were, and hip-hop was. It's a 1973 van. Even back then, the nickname was the Hoopty, right? The Hoopty, God rest his soul, is probably in a junkyard somewhere now. But he said, you could take that Hoopty and go pick kids up. And sure enough, we picked literally hundreds and hundreds of kids up in that Hoopty. Kids that didn't go to church. Kids that didn't have any church clothes. Kids that didn't have any church etiquette. First place I went is, I said, you sure, Pastor? Because I'm going down to the projects. It's only 9 blocks away. I'm going to go down there and pick some kids up. Those kids need Jesus. Ain't nobody else going down there. So I went down there and started a basketball league and started inviting kids, and they started jumping in the van, and they came to church in their church clothes, their white tees, and their wife beaters, and their shorts, and their sneakers. Came to church wearing a hat. We didn't yell at them to take their hat off like a lot of churches do, right? Sometimes you'll catch me wearing a hat when I'm preaching here. What? I just do that to ruffle some feathers with some people. Like, if you can't get over this, like, I don't know if you belong here. I love you, but anyways, right? But they came, like, with their hats on, with their, you know, with their sneakers on, with their gold chains, tatted up, twisted up, dreaded up, messed up, smelling like weed. But they came, and God began to change their hearts. And there was a revolution that started to happen. And some of these kids started to bring their parents to church. And they started to bring their friends to church. And they say, hey, man, there's this place where we can go, and we can be safe, and we can be ourselves. And they don't yell at us, and we can dress however. And we like the music, and we understand what's being said. And God is doing something in my life. And it was amazing. Come on, make some noise for that. And there's a guy that's here in this service. I'm going to just put him on the spot because he was one of those guys that I picked up in the van when he was just a young, as he would say, jit back in the day. But he's still here at Crossover, and he brings his family to church now. So give it up for my boy Long Boy. Say what's up, man. Tell him what Crossover, the impact Crossover has made on your life. Man, you can stand up and show him how big you are now.
You love putting me on the spot, don't you? On the real though, first and foremost, when Paul talked about how him and Timothy planted and watered seeds and God gave the increase, I can say that you practice what you preach. Yeah, I can definitely say that. He used to send this ugly, raggedy van, busted up van through the projects.
But we tatted it up with some graffiti.
Yeah, it still was ugly. But I was already gone. I was already in the streets. I probably was 12, 13 years old. We used to have 2 or 3 stolen cars parked around the corner. We would joyride. But he put us in a van, and I truly believe in my heart. I had a praying grandmother behind closed doors, but nobody was pouring the word into me. Nobody was sitting me down, praying over me, praying for me. I believe the seeds that he planted was the seeds that got me where I'm at today. And now where I'm at in my life, I've been at Crossover probably 5 years. I teach it to my children. I teach them the word. I sit down, my family right back there. I pray with them, everything. And I understand the importance of community. I understand the importance of friends and family, brothers and sisters in Christ to hold you accountable. When you go into those dark caves and you going through something and you distance, That's where the enemy wants y'all at. So if you got friends and family that's going to hold you accountable, man, that's everything. So crossover has definitely impacted my life, and I'm forever grateful to Pastor Tommy.
Love you, bro. I just want to brag on Longboy for a second. Some of y'all have seen a minister here. He's an artist as well, has some incredible music. Look him up. But I'm also just proud of him. Like, he was from the projects. You know, that's where he grew up. That's all he knew. But he got around some other people that were believers in Jesus and not only began to change his mind spiritually, but began to disciple him and help him and mentor him. And not just me, but there was many others. And people were just examples and role models that he never got to see. And, like, he was out there in the streets doing a lot of illegal stuff. But then he came to the Lord and was started doing legal stuff. And it's hard for a while. It's hard. He wasn't making the kind of money he was making before. But he, you know, and it was got challenging at times. And sometimes we could be tempted to go back. But he didn't go back. He just kept planting the good seeds. And listen, the good fruit takes longer to grow, but it tastes so much better. So much more worth it. And, you know, remember picking him up in the van in the projects, and now, like, you know, in the last couple of years, him and his wife, they became homeowners. First ones in their family. This brother got a CDL license. He's driving. He's, like, he's making a good living, an honest living for his family. He's got hopes and dreams. And see, that's what happens when God begins to work in your life. You don't just get stuck in the situation of maybe the generational cycles that your family was in, but God breaks that and moves you up and elevates you and sets things up for the generations to come. Amen? So thank God we had a church that was open to reaching the city, because the youth ministry just exploded over those next couple years. And, you know, the church got, the floor got dirty, things got broken, all kinds of stuff took place. But, man, crossover was open and said, man, bring these kids in. Bring these young adults in. Bring them in. We want to love them. We want to point them to Jesus. And much like the story when Pastor Chuck Smith in this movie, when he opened the door for the hippies, they filled up his little church, and God started moving in amazing ways, and people were complaining. So he came up with a little solution for those dirty feet. Check this out. So how do you start a Jesus revolution like that? Here's the second thing, y'all. Create a place where everyone is welcome. Everyone say everyone.
Everyone.
With God's help, that's what we have created here at Crossover Church. We created this multi-ethnic, multi-generational, multi-class church. We love our city. Jesus said in John 3:16, y'all know it's the most famous scripture in the Bible, even if you didn't grow up in church. For God so loved the what? The world. He loved the world. He loved everybody. Hip-hoppers, hippies, black, white, brown, young, old, rich, poor, loved everyone. Right? Galatians 3:28, Paul says, there is no longer Jew or Gentile, slave or free, male or female, for you are what? One in Christ Jesus. Now watch this. And now that you belong to Christ, you are true children of Abraham. You are his heirs. And as God's promise to Abraham, it belongs to you. God's promise to Abraham belongs to you. Look at the person next to you and say, you have an inheritance. How many of y'all ever wish you had a rich uncle that had like $1 million to give you an inheritance, right? My uncle was here last Sunday. He's not rich, but he's rich in faith, right? He's rich in spiritually and in all kinds of different wisdom and whatnot, right? But guess what? You do have a rich ancestor, Abraham. Right, and the Bible says, like, we get to tap into that inheritance, which is things here on earth and especially things to come. And that's for you, and that's for me. And so if you're here today and this is your first time, or maybe you've only been a few times, I want to tell you as the lead pastor here, like, listen, you are welcome here. If you're hurting, you're welcome here. If you're broken, you're welcome here. If you're searching, you're welcome here. If you've been divorced, you're welcome here. If you're going through depression, you are welcome here. If you're struggling financially, you're welcome here. If you're struggling with a place to live, you're welcome here. If you're struggling with addiction, you are welcome here, because freedom is here. Hope is here. God has a plan for your life. He's got good things. He's got amazing things in store. You just got to open up and say, God, yes. Yes, here I am. I receive, and it'll meet you right here. You can find a home right here at Crossover, y'all. The third way we started Jesus Revolution is this. Number three, we lead people into an authentic relationship with Jesus. Listen, ever since Crossover Church was started, every time we have an opportunity to share the gospel, to give people an invitation, we're about that life. We do that here at Crossover. That's part of our DNA. So we do that at outreaches. We do that at church services. We do that at concerts. Like, we're regularly explaining the good news. We got those good news shoes on, right? We're sharing the good news, the gospel of Jesus with people that, man, you've messed up. I've messed up. We've messed up. We can't fix it. We can't get right with God. So God sent his only son, Jesus, to fix it, to pay our sentence, to pay our debt. He took care of it. And all we have to do is say yes and make a commitment then to follow him, make him the Lord of our life. The Lord means leader. God, you're going to be the leader, and I'm going to follow. Some of us aren't good at following. You want to be a leader. Well, guess what? You also got to learn to follow. First and foremost, you got to learn to follow your creator, the one that made you, designed you, has a plan for your life. Even just this year so far, we've seen hundreds of people start a relationship with Jesus right here at Crossover Church. Some days more than 101 Sunday. This year so far at Crossover Church, we've seen over 100 people get baptized and publicly display that. Go under the water and, man, we go crazy and celebrate. We're going to have more baptisms coming up. Stay tuned. I know some of y'all have been asking, and some people have come up to me today, like, we got some baptisms coming up. Stay tuned. You could be a part of it, right? Since we moved into this old Toys R Us store, this used to be Toys R Us if you didn't know, we've baptized almost 1,800 people in the last 12 years. Man, that's a Jesus revolution, for real. You've been part of it right here in the middle of the mix. And in this movie, Jesus Revolution, Pastor Chuck Smith, he kind of helped birth this. And I definitely encourage you guys to go watch the movie. They did beach baptisms there in California. And there was this place called Pirates Cove, and they would go down there and baptized people. And literally thousands and thousands of people got baptized at Pirates Cove. And even to this day, it's like a spot where people get baptized regularly. Pastor Greg Laurie, just a couple of months ago, who was actually even around at the beginning of when all this stuff was happening with the Jesus Revolution, he leads a large church. They just did a baptism there a couple of months ago that some articles report it was like the largest baptism ever in the United States at one time. Over 4,000 people got baptized in one day. That's like a Book of Acts moment at this very place. And so one of the key people that was in the movie, like this girl, was the one that was kind of bringing him to church and talking to him about Jesus. And he wasn't sure at first, but he was searching and he was curious, and the Holy Spirit was working on his heart, like he might be working on some of your hearts today. And they went to one of those beach baptisms at Pirates Cove, and she was getting baptized. And I want you to check out what happened. Check this out. How many of y'all know Jesus is still into revolutionizing lives, changing hearts, changing trajectories, changing generations? That's what he does. Right here today, back to school Sunday, 2023. It's no accident that you're here. Maybe somebody invited you here today. Maybe you came to get some backpacks for your kids. Maybe you didn't even know that was going on, but you find yourself here today. But God is tapping you on the shoulder. God is drawing you in. Customize today this message for you, because he wants to spark a revolution in your life, in your family. And then there's others here that he wants you to be the revolution. He wants you to reach other people around you. And this message today is going to get that flame lit inside of you and inspire you to have different eyes when you look around, and to love your neighbor and love your city every day and be observant. So I want you to bow your heads today around the room. If you're worshiping online, if you would pause and pray with us. And you're here today and God's tapping you on the shoulder. Maybe you've never had an authentic relationship with Jesus before. Or maybe you've been close to God at one time, but there's been distance, and maybe today is your moment to come back home and reconnect with God. If that's you, I just simply want to pray for you today. It's not an accident that you're here. It's not an accident that you're connected, streaming this right now online. But if that's you and you're in this room, I want you to just go ahead and raise your hand. I want to pray for you in just a moment. Awesome. I see you. Worshiping online, you could just type in the chat, pray for me. Be sure to pray for you as well. All of you that raise your hand in this room or in your rooms, I want to invite you to say this prayer with me. And make these words, your heart's cry. But I do want to say this, beyond you saying this prayer, you're saying yes to Jesus, asking for forgiveness, making a commitment to follow him. But beyond that, now you're starting a relationship. Somebody say relationship. It's not religion, it's a relationship. And a relationship deals with communication. You gotta start talking to God on a daily basis. Say, Pastor Tommy, how do I do that? It's pretty easy, it's called prayer. You don't have to use some big fancy churchy words. Just talk to God like I'm talking to you right now. Have a conversation with him. How does he talk back to you? Well, that's the second part. Number two, you gotta read his word daily. Even if it's just a few scriptures. Download the Bible app. Do a Bible reading plan. Do a devotional. God can speak to you through his words and through lots of different things. But reading his word and growing and learning is so key. And then the last step I want to encourage you with is you got to have community around you. Somebody say community. You got to have a faith community of some people around you that can encourage you, that can challenge you, that can check you, that can laugh with you, cry with you, pray with you, be there for you. And there's some great people here at Crossover. This is a great faith community if you're looking for one. So if you're serious about those steps, I want to invite you to say this prayer with me. Make these words yours. Say, Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for your love. Thank you for Jesus, your son, came down to the earth, died on the cross for my mistakes, my sins, my issues. And I believe what the Bible says, that he resurrected 3 days later. And because of that, I can have new life. And that's what I ask for today. Give me that new life. And I admit I've messed up. I've sinned. I've asked you to forgive me. Make me brand new, inside and out. Help me to represent you and start a Jesus revolution in my city. Thank you for loving me, bringing me here today, talking to me, reaching me, in Jesus' name. Keep your heads bowed. If you're here and you already have a relationship with Jesus, but you would say, Pastor T, I want to be that revolution. I need to represent more. I need to be that messenger that it talks about in Romans chapter 10. If that's you, I want you to raise your hand. I want to pray for you. Father, I lift up my family, my brothers and sisters around this room and in rooms all over that are saying they want to be the revolution. They want to be the ones that are the messengers. They want to wear their gospel shoes and represent you everywhere they go. I just pray that you'll use them this very week. And like I said in the last service, God, I believe it's true for this service as well. I believe there's people in this room that you're going to use this very week. This very week. To save somebody's life. There's people around us that are depressed and struggling and addicted and broken. And they feel like they're suffocating and drowning. And God, I believe there's some people that are right here, right now with a hand up. You're going to use them to save somebody's life this week. Help us to be obedient when your Holy Spirit taps us on the shoulder to go talk to someone or pray with someone or move in a certain direction. Help us to move with you, Lord. Use us to be your hands and feet at Crossover Church. We thank you for the revolution that we've been a part of. But God, I'm believing today that what we've seen is just the beginning. And our next season is going to be the biggest season and the most impactful season that we've ever seen. I declare that today in Jesus' name. Everyone said, amen. Amen. Come on, make some noise for Jesus. Go be that revolution. I love y'all.